Welcome to the Po Show, broadcasting live from Zenda TV in Los Angeles. This is where we elevate the creative cult. This is where creatives can be seen. So thanks for tuning in. Thanks for always watching us. I'm Po. So on Sunday, April 23rd, from 2 to 10 p.m., the Rainbow Bar and Grill 45th Anniversary Party, 9015 West Sunset Boulevard, West Hollywood. The famed Rainbow Bar and Grill celebrating its 45th anniversary with an epic party in the parking lot. An outdoor stage with performances by, you know, Quiet Riot, Black and Blue, Jet Boy, Westville Massacre, and the Streetwalkin' Cheetahs. Gates open at 2 p.m. Admission is free with a two-drink minimum. So I'll see you there, of course. On May 4th through the 6th, Homegrown at the Bootleg Theater, 2220 Beverly Boulevard in Los Angeles. A refreshing approach to collaborative self-production of Los Angeles dance, redefining notions of the do-it-all-yourself mindset that's pervasive in LA's performing arts landscape. Homegrown activates true collaboration among dance makers, a theater, and a service organization. Choreographers share the stage, stretch artistic development beyond limited showcase festival formats, bolster production skills, and attract dynamic audiences. Tickets are $20 in advance, $25 at the door. For more info, visit bootlegtheater.org. And one more. You ready? On Saturday, May 6th, from 4 to 7 p.m., Book Club Going Native opening reception at the Durden and Ray Gallery, 1923 South Santa Fe Avenue, Los Angeles. A unique cultural experience, an art exhibition and performances based on the book Going Native by Stephen Wright. Enjoy the happening. Whether you read the dark comic novel or not, you're encouraged to take a peek. A chilling and often brilliant novel, a novel that radiates the dark, consuming energy of a black hole. That's what the New York Times says. The book is available on Amazon. Title, again, is Going Native. Author, Stephen Wright. For more info, visit durdenandray.com. I believe that's a new gallery in Los Angeles, so definitely check that out. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain. Okay, so today, once again, I am so fortunate, co-hosting with me from all the way from East London, from one of the street art capitals of the world, the owner of Hidden Streets of London, wall broker and urban art promoter, Danny Wood.
What's up, Poe? How's it going? It's good to be back.
Fantastic. Are you taking autographs later?
Yeah, always. Yeah, people have started recognizing me in the street and everything now. So it's
are they?
Good.
Wow, that must be Danny Wood.
It is.
Woohoo!
Now that's a bit of an exaggeration.
Hey, did you ever go see Scott Glazer yet?
No, from by the ink.
God, do it, for God's sake.
I'm in tattoo need.
Have you been there yet?
No.
Speakeasy tattoo. He's working on one.
Since I left the UK. So yeah, I'm
Are you shaking?
Itching for one. No, I'm itching for one. I need one.
You
I
have
go 3 months, but then as soon as I'm there, I just cry in the chair all day for 3 hours.
Just
so,
cry
yeah,
in the
I'm
chair.
A weed when it comes to tattoos, and anyone who says it doesn't.
Weed?
Yeah, a weed, as in like a little fucking plant, you know. Like,
I have no idea what you say most of the time.
Well,
okay.
Language barriers and all that.
Yes. Okay, along with an LA-based artist exercising the power of words, sharing with the world motivational and inspirational messages, a writer doing time in Hollywood. Wordsmith!
Woo! Hey.
Okay,
but we don't know what he looks like. And an LA-based artist working on an international stage to spread positive messages paired with zany imagery. MEGZANY!
Hey!
What's up?
She not afraid. Look at how brave this girl
Woo!
Is.
Ow!
Got him. Girl power.
Get him.
Okay. So, I love what you guys do. I mean, what else, what more do we need than some positive
Never mind this. I'm just happy this is.
Yeah, what is your deal? This you're over there on social media.
No, but we're trying for the first time to do it on Facebook Live.
No, I'm not trying for the first time.
I am.
You're trying.
Yeah, but it's working. Like, it's on my Facebook
Live. Okay, we got it.
Yeah, okay. Well, everyone knows I'm a... Anyway, fuck it, whatever.
Okay, so tell you, okay. let's distract you from your Facebook Live. So, and talk about these people.
Yeah, so us guys have been friends, we were just saying outside.
It's not proper English.
Several years now.
Either country.
Several years now on media, but we actually only met... I met you last year, didn't I, Meg, and you in London for the first time. So I just saying outside, this is the first time we can actually say we have street artists because they're painted on the street rather than the wall. And you're going to see their work all over Los Angeles. I've been just chatting to people earlier on, and even though they don't know you or street art, they know both your works because you're prolific. Yeah, you've got, hit me with a number in terms of how many pieces you've
got.
Hit
him over the head.
Currently writing right now, I don't know, but there's a lot, which is massive to say for street artists because pieces get buffed often.
Yeah.
And it's kind of insane. I just walked by, I did my strawberry shortcake piece, and there was other people starting to clamor on the wall, and they got buffed.
Don't be a dick.
Still there. Yeah, don't be a dick.
I love that so much.
It's
one of my favorites.
Still writing, and it's just kind of insane that I didn't get buffed with the other people, so I'm really, it's really amazing.
Yeah, and I've had, I don't know, thousands of pieces, you know what I mean? I actually spent 1 year when I was first starting in 2014, posting a new piece every day of the year, you know what I mean? So I did 365, and it started off just because I was having fun, and I was doing something every day, but then after a couple months, it became a challenge, and that was kind of cool, but.
And by the nature of your work, you're doing most of it in the studio, right? Because you're with your stencil that's pre-made, and then you're coming out with a paste-up like the one that you did in London with me.
Yeah. That's the whole point of stencils, you know what I mean? It allows you to do stuff in the streets very quickly. Mm-hmm. I think that's the reason they were invented. So, the preparation for that, any size, you know what I mean? I started off with what I call posted stamp size pieces, and now I'm doing, 25 and 50 foot pieces, and it all still leans on the stencil, especially where the typewriter's concerned.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Okay.
Which is the way you do it is, I'm not going to say irrelevant, but the power of your work is in the words.
Yeah.
You're a writer by trade.
Absolutely. That's why this whole thing works for me. Like, first and foremost.
Well, it seems to work for everybody because you're a huge phenomenon.
Yeah. I mean, as a writer, I love hearing that. But it works for me because, first and foremost, I am a writer. I love to write in a lot of different mediums. I got the crazy notion one day to try to do street art and utilize that medium. And it's just completely taken off. And I'm having a great time. But to your point, now, and I said this in interviews, I'm getting read on a daily basis all over the world, and for any writer, that's just living the dream.
So this is interesting because street art, urban art in general, that's one huge plus is you get to be seen.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Writers have that same issue, like see me, read me, so it's interesting what you're doing. You're like breaking through a whole box is what you're doing right now.
Yeah, and it was very, I want to say almost accidental. You know what I mean? Again, I started doing this.
All brilliance is accidental.
And I agree with that. Like, I started doing it for me. I started, and I was very passionate about it. But early on, I saw the words were resonating with people. And then it was a snowball effect.
You said something about crazy, and this is interesting. I was just thinking about this again, though I've done like a whole segment on it before. But, I study the brain and neurology and all the weird stuff, and as far as the line between creativity and insanity is very fine.
Absolutely.
And they go from side to side. That's the truth. It's the way our mind works, because the chaos is on the the creative brilliant side, that anything's possible.
Yeah.
So that's where we ride. So.
Yeah. I think just staying with Wordsmith a second, your work is one of the, I say this all the time, but people can relate to it who have no love or knowledge or interest in street art, right? Because it's words, which we all...
Powerful words.
Yeah, and the amount of times I see people, or you posting, people stood by quotes of yours about marriage or whatever, there's something
ridiculous
for everyone.
Yeah,
you know?
For sure.
Yeah, and I say this, and I'm very modest, but I say this, like, I think it does fall apart if I'm a shitty writer, you know what I mean? But
for sure.
I'm writing
hold.
But the great thing is I'm writing things that resonate somewhere in my life. Like, I don't put anything up on a wall because I'm like, people are going to love this, or this is going to look great on a t-shirt.
No, of course.
I'm putting up words that mean something to me, and the fact that they are resonating just with so many people,
makes
or just with
just
the masses.
You. Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. It's crazy.
Okay, let's show the video so that we know kind of what we're even talking about. This is going to go, just a warning, this is going to go by super fast. You're not going to be able to probably read it, but you'll get the idea. And there's lots of people in it going, yeah, look at this. This is what, and there's lots of joy and happiness and togetherness and people
which
falling
in love.
Which is
what art's all about.
Okay, so check it out.
That's a lot of work, man.
Wow, thanks.
No, that's not even all of it. That's back to 2016. I was just telling him there's no way I could capture all your work. Because you've been doing, okay, so 2013?
Yeah, late 2013, I got the crazy notion.
I was
notion.
Not going to go back for 4 years.
Yeah, and I keep saying I got the crazy notion to do this. But
craziness, good
yeah.
thing.
And it really was. Like, I actually thought superheroes did street art because it just appears overnight.
We've had a few of them on here.
Yeah. Yeah, I just didn't think I didn't think I could do it, but again, when you get that passionate idea, and the idea, again, I'm a writer, so the idea kind of popped in my head, if I do street art, it would be word-based. If it's word-based, there would be an image of a typewriter, and then the page mm-hmm. coming out of it. Like, it was so simple mm-hmm. to me,
yep.
and it was actually so simple I had to Google to see if anybody had done it before, mm-hmm. and here's the kicker, once I saw nobody did, I got over all that fear and, oh, a superhero's do it and I can't do it, and I just dove in.
Like Shakespeare says, words, words, words.
Yeah, there you go.
That's all it takes. Okay, we're going to give you another example. There's a pretty short video of you painting in West Palm Beach, a very inspirational few words, so check it out. And I think, are you painting over? Yes.
Thank you.
yo, I'm drunk.
Polina was experimenting with the fan up her skirt then during the break.
Oh, yeah. I see why Marilyn stayed there for so long. Good grief. But that was hot. Why didn't her legs burn?
Because
she's just smoking hot.
There's a good video. Good video about Batman there. Shouts
okay, we want to know about Miss Zany. The Zany Miss Zany.
What's happening?
What's your deal?
Wow.
What's up with you?
I left the corporate world. I was there for 8 years, and I just was kind of like, fuck it, I don't want to be there anymore.
That's long
Same.
Draining. Yeah. And then I've always had an affinity for street art. And never thought that my art was good enough to be in the streets.
That's your first mistake. Nobody should ever feel that way, ever.
Right? Well, yeah.
To be anywhere. Express yourself.
Yeah, I quit being a jerk to myself, basically. And
don't
decided.
Be a dick.
What were you doing before? What was your corporate job?
I was a corporate recruiter.
Right, okay.
Engineers and junk.
Yeah, cool.
So, I still love engineer people. They're really amazing, but...
Yeah, they're creative, innovative people.
They are. But yeah, now on to bigger and better and radder things, traveling all the time. And
okay, let's check out really quick what she does in the flash of an eye, flash of a bulb, flash of a something.
Holy shit, that's a lot of work, man. And I was going to say, how many years was that over off mark? And you said, a year?
A year.
So how many people? That's hundreds of pieces.
It's hundreds of pieces and just a shit ton of cities, too.
Yeah, tell us where you've been.
I want to go of cities. Just before we go in terms of
for
cities.
Show.
So we actually hung out in East London, didn't we? We managed to get some downtime from you guys. We had a few beers. We caught up. Now, there's a lot of work there that you guys did in London. And we were talking about the permission, non-permission, legal, illegal, whatever the fuck you want to call it, off camera. Now, you got a lot of work there on the famous British red postbox, right? Now, I'm guessing there's no permission given there.
No.
So what's happening? You're rocking up. You're doing it. You're just doing it in the street in the day.
Who's going to bitch about that? Those are all like inspirational, motivational, like, fuck you, London, if you don't like that.
That's what we like to think. We're beautifying,
not
destroying.
No,
and that is an unused portion of the box. You know what I mean? The boxes are amazing. They're actually starting to disappear, which is a shame.
Yeah. But
the three sides are glass, but they had this back that used to be advertising, but that fell to the wayside years ago. So we just looked at it and said, you know, measured it out and cut pieces and prepared it, and they fit perfectly in there, and everybody's like, it just adds
they
to
were
the
made for your work.
D7606
and your work,
who we all know, he actually reached out to me, and I never put two and two together till just now. He's in we need to get him on, actually. He's over in June.
He'll be here in May.
Yeah, May. Sorry. Yeah. He reached out to me and I've just put it together. He wanted to know the dimensions of a phone box, right? I'm guessing that was for you to do your cutting, right? Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I think I did ask at one point, yeah.
Okay. Before, he's like, dude, I need to know. You messaged me the one day, I don't suppose you know the dimensions of a red phone box, do you? Yeah. And I'm like, yeah, sure, let me just check my phone.
Yeah, it's a shame. They disappear too. Somebody is cleaning it or buffing it, but it's great when they last, or as long as they last, because we put them, most of those phone boxes are like in the Covent Garden area, mm-hmm. where there's no street art.
Yeah.
So this is us being innovative, mm-hmm. and resourceful and finding a way to get art up.
So
that's
when they
not
take
destroying property, so
when
but adding.
When yeah. it's taken down, then what's there?
It's
nothing.
Just red.
It goes back
it's just
to
a
ugly
red,
red
square.
I mean,
like,
red's not ugly, but it's just, it goes to a blank space.
Yeah. It used to be advertising that was put in there, like vinyl banners for
advertising. The point there being, I guess, would be a touchy subject for back home, is that it's part to do with like the monarch in terms of you know, Elizabeth. So maybe that means she's a fan of street art. I don't know. Shouts to Liz, our queen.
Yeah.
What did you,
yeah.
How do you do the wave?
It's
you
like
know how to do the
wrist,
wave.
Wrist, elbow.
I don't know. I got no idea. I'm
you
not.
You don't know how to do the wave?
Why the fuck would I?
Are you from London?
No, I'm from Worcester, but I live in.
Are you from England?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, we better take a break. You know what? Before we take a break, let's go to Just Food for Dogs, and then we'll go into break. Check it out. Big idea expressed in the smallest way. An invention that will revolutionize the musical instrument industry. A GPS tracking system for musical instruments that syncs with your mobile device, helping in the instant recovery of lost or stolen gear.
Million instruments each year in the United States alone, we're not even talking internationally, are stolen. And of that, only 3% are recovered.
Disturbing topic. I would say it's an epidemic.
Musical yeah. instrument is not a tool. It is an extension of the artistry
exactly.
of the musician.
Exactly.
The emotional connection, the loss of instruments, goes far beyond the replacement value.
Even know about the music industry?
Well, there are many facets of this wonderful wild world of live music in particular. Also one of the producers of a long-running show called Ultimate Jam Night, which is now at the
worked
with bands for a long time, individual bands managing artists, simply trying to make musicians' lives better and make their lives easier, because it's difficult to be a
yeah.
musician. It really
yeah.
is. Actually have a two-way type of communication. So it allows you to marry up with your instrument and your instrument to marry up to you.
Aw, that's so sweet. Adam, tell us more.
It's about that marriage that should go on forever.
Yeah. A big deal in a small package. Wrap all this up in a nice little tiny package in your instrument. Phone's ringing off the hook here. Can you give
yeah.
these people more
yeah.
information? How
yeah.
can they get this?
Well, first
Hey, welcome back to the Hollywood Post Show. So on Sunday, May 7th at 11:45 a.m. to 5 p.m., Ride for Ronnie, the third annual motorcycle ride and concert at Los Encinos State Historic Park, 16756 Moore Park Street, Encino, California. Raising money for the Ronnie James Dio Stand Up and Shout Cancer Fund. All proceeds go towards helping to find a cure. Live music, food trucks, raffles, live auction, beer and wine, and vendors. Riders check in at Harley-Davidson of Glendale, where they enjoy a continental breakfast. Kickstands up at 11 o'clock. Participants depart Glendale, traveling the freeways of the North San Fernando Valley down the 405 to a rally and live concert at 11:45 at Los Encinos State Historic Park. Tickets sales coming soon. For more info, visit docancerfund.org, and I will totally see you there on my Harley. Just kidding. I did used to have a Harley. Okay, on Saturday, May 13th, 7 to 8 p.m., Revolution Resolution at Kinship Studios, 5612 North Figueroa Street, Los Angeles. The secret of change is to focus all your energy not on fighting the old, but on building the new. Who said it? Socrates, I guess. I didn't hear him say it. Celebrate Mother's Day by taking your mother to a family-friendly acrobatics and aerial dance show. Our desire to change, to be part of something for the greater good, is sparked by the desire for revolution for each of us as an individual to change our lives for the better. When we change our lives, we change the world. For ticket info, visit EEPURL.com. Again, that's EEPURL.com. I don't know what that stands for. Arrive early for snacks and drinks provided by the narrators and the Healthy Happy Food Bar. So check that stuff out. Looks interesting, sounds interesting. Support the creatives, no matter what it is. Music, get on your motorbike, ride for the cause. Check out the awesome musicians that are going to be there. Definitely go to that website and see who's going to play, because I'm not really positive who is, but there will be rock stars on every corner. Okay. So let's get back to it. I want to go to this really quickly because I want to make sure it gets in. This is about MEGZANY's work, and this was recently posted. This was just March 16th. Chris Adams. Did you see that?
What's up?
It's like a super short video. I guess he does these promoting LA street artists, Streets of LA, MEGZANY episode 2, I think is what it was. Check it out.
I was walking around the streets and I got to discover MEGZANY. She has a way of adding a message and humor. When I was a kid, we were homeless, living in a car with my mother and my stepfather. And one of the many things that got me through the tough times was art. You know, we didn't always have food, but we always had art. So I want to thank all street artists for doing what they do. Please keep creating.
So keep doing it, right?
Of course, yeah. Yeah.
We're just talking about the boxes. What do you call them? The electric
utility
boxes.
Utility boxes.
What are they?
Oh, the utility boxes.
Yeah. So that's where I see most of your guys work.
Are you excited about it?
Yeah. So I want to know how that permission or scenario came around, and you just said you're sharing one with someone, so you're rotating it, etc. And you've got I've seen them in Hollywood, Venice,
that's city,
downtown,
that's city permission,
all
though,
over.
Right? You
get.
Yeah,
or not.
Words like no. There was no.
Maybe we don't want to talk about.
No, we do.
I might have. I think less than. I have a couple that the city have given me that I actually can show paperwork. And then the other is just Renegade.
But you can just change that paperwork for the Renegade.
Well, that's the thing. Once you have that paperwork,
that, but there are certain boxes that I've tried to talk to the city about that I really want, and they for some reason they want to give me the roundabout and ridiculous ask the stakeholders to give you a letter. Really? No, I'm just gonna do it.
The problem is with this, especially with the city, as you guys call it, or the councils back home, you never get to speak to the right person, and it's kind of like you're going through hoops and you never get anywhere. But the Renegade illegal, you stand there with a high-vis vest on, people see that all day, every day, in every walk of their life, and you don't, your mind doesn't go, oh, I wonder what that person's doing. You just assume they're fixing something or painting something.
Yeah.
You said an interesting thing, though. You said that the most work you've seen of ours is on utility boxes. I got to be honest, I don't like hearing that, because it's such a small percentage. But here's the thing. The reason we do those utility boxes are they're ugly gray and we're beautifying them, but they are everywhere.
But you know, the other hugely positive part of that is their people, the interaction with people is absolutely bigger than anything else.
A car on the street, you just see it when it's not gray. No, nobody notices them when they're gray. They're just ugly as hell. But we're adding to, we're Hell's beautifying the city. We're adding to the experience of the city.
You have two on Washington towards the beach, one outside of hairdressers, and one on the other. And that, the footfall there,
absolutely.
Those four traffic lights. Yeah. That's one thing that really pisses me off. Sorry, just going off piece. The traffic
Are you
light.
Going off?
The traffic light thing here with having to wait and cross and whatever. Anyway.
Having to wait your turn? Yeah. I know, it sucks, right?
You can just walk out and then...
I think the last episode with those girls, you were complaining about that because they called you a jackass.
But then you threw them
a British accent and they let you go.
Pleaded ignorance, the same as everything else.
A cool thing is, too, that we love to do, like, anytime artists come from another city, we like to offer them half of the box. Yeah. And so that's really awesome.
You want half my box, honey?
Yeah. They share boxes,
I have the whole thing, but I give you half.
I mean, this is the whole urban art world through and through. It's such a fucking open, friendly community,
an open box.
And even and it's also a small community across
Absolutely.
The world.
Very
and if like I said, we were friends before we met each other, and we were just talking about D7 and C3, a mutual friends of ours off camera, and they're going to come over. We're going to hang around.
Absolutely.
You'll go out pasting with them and doing some work. And there's that. We were just going on about how much you travel. And you just want to paint. You don't want to go.
But the beautiful thing about how much travel we do is that part of it. Like if we're going anywhere, like we were just going to Berlin for the first time, and we reached out, and I forgot how we found it, but we found this photographer. She got paint for us before we arrived, had planned out where we were going to hit, and it allowed us to do 6 hours of
what
work.
What does that
in
tell
like
you when you have such a support group worldwide?
It's incredible. Yeah. It's fantastic.
Okay, let's check out this Playboy video real quick so we stay on schedule, because this has a wealth of information.
I wrote a word once that says street art is merely paint and paper, plus gallons of passion and reams of gumption. And I think that's the essence of it. We as street artists are rebels because we are going out there and risking a lot to put our art on the streets. It takes a lot of guts to kind of go out there and do what we do. I am the LA-based artist known as WRDSMTH.
What's your biggest challenge as a street artist?
I think dancing that line of legality. There's a lot of people that love what we're doing, you know, in the streets and in cities, and there's a lot of people that think it is, you know, graffiti and vandalism. I'll never paint on private property, but again, I'm dancing a line when I put a piece up on an abandoned wall or an abandoned store or even a utility box. But again, it's what we do, and a lot of people are embracing it. The city is even starting to embrace it. It's a great time for street art. I think it's a great time for street art in Los Angeles. I personally think there's a renaissance going on. You can find my art in cities across the country, Los Angeles, San Diego, New Orleans, Philadelphia, New York, and overseas. I'm up in London and Paris and Edinburgh. And Melbourne, Australia. I'm also up in Q Art Gallery here in Los Angeles. I just had a show that featured over 28 pieces. I'm very proud of the body of work, and it was a phenomenal event.
We're in Marina Del Rey now, and we're going to get a behind-the-scenes look at how WRDSMTH puts up a new word.
I am a writer, first and foremost. I have always been a writer. I did not know if I could do street art, and even if I could do it, I didn't know what I would say. When you're older, you're not going to look back and say, I shouldn't have chased my dream when I was younger. It's going to be quite the opposite. You have to take the success wherever you can get it, and somehow I caught lightning in a bottle. For me as a writer, it's a phenomenal opportunity.
Okay, Miss MEGZANY.
Yes.
Okay, so San Francisco MoMA, not Mama. Mama. MoMA.
MoMA.
MoMA, MoMA. So you were doing some prep for that. Let's check out that video and then we'll talk about that a little bit. Check it out. Okay, so that's awesome.
Yeah.
Talk about it. Talk about your process and your inspiration as far as, I know you're into the women thing, which is very cool. And
yeah, I mean, for the woman thing, it's kind of like,
sorry I put it that way, but it's just a woman thing.
Yeah,
it's,
and I hate, you know what I mean, that it is that way.
That it's a thing.
I'm not like this uber crazy ass feminist. Yeah. I'm just for equality. Yeah. Like, and I think that everyone should be on an equal playing field.
Yeah.
And I just think that like anything that I'm going through personally, like courage has no gender. I wrote that for myself. Like I was just in a shitty spot.
It's an affirmation.
And I just that's actually like one of the pieces that I
or no up. Color or you could add any, you know, other word to the end of that.
But I put that up on the Pride Parade route and it wasn't even finished. It was nowhere near where I wanted it to be. But I was like, I just have to get this out there because I think the message is really amazing. And I put it up and I kind of walked away and cut all.
I did something. No, because you're inspiring people. That's the thing, is you're putting out the message. It doesn't matter if it was ready or if you were, you know, or if it was perfect. You put out a message.
Yeah.
And just like you do, that's what your art is. It's your messages, your positive affirmations and messages that you're putting out there. That's
definitely
beautiful. That's fucking beautiful.
It's a lot.
Fucking beautiful fucking together beautiful. Are so amazing. Those are great words together.
It's a t-shirt.
It's a t-shirt. It's fucking
gonna be
beautiful.
On your next piece now. It's fucking beautiful.
You guys have done some stuff together, and there was actually this dude, Shoreditch, guided tour. Do you know who does the guided tour? Probably a lot of people do the guided tours.
There's a couple of firms.
This one particular person, I don't think I got his name, but he was talking about you guys in Shoreditch. Saw Wordsmith's work, and then, but there was like, what happened at the same time, this other stuff started popping up, found that it was MEGZANY. Did some stalking of her online to find her name.
She's a
appeared, Curious Meshes appeared on a wall in Brick Lane. Searching online revealed to be MEGZANY. Says it knows how to spray a clean single layer stencil. Images evoking sentiment about objectification, exploitation of women and mermaids. Placing them in vending machines. Okay, so this is the coolest part, is that besides the art, of course, that's great and being recognized, but great to see artists from a city so noted for its creativity coming all the way to London to brighten up a rather dull summer. Mm-hmm. How cool is that?
That is.
So let's say, go LA!
I mean, Brick Lane's changed a lot. I mean, I used to live on Brick Lane.
Yeah, I know, you said that.
It's changed a lot, and it's a victim of its own success, like anything. It's become, you know, there's all the local business being pushed out, but it's one of the said
everywhere.
Places that you can say that people will know it in the art world. People know, you know.
Brick Lane Coffee. You know, I love that place.
Yeah.
I mean, that's where we met at the Illustrated Seminar.
I know,
in
the brewery.
2015. There's another one this year. I'll be sharing that.
I know, every year now.
Yeah, I agree. It has changed. And, even while I've been active, but I think it's still awesome. Like I make at least one awesome trip every sure. time I'm yeah. there, and we get more creative. Like mm-hmm. it has become crazy, like trying to find space, but you just have to get more creative, yeah. and that's what we do about you getting up high. And getting yeah, up getting higher. High. Yeah, yeah. yeah.
Let's yeah. look at these collabs from you two. These are cool. more recent. August 2016 in Chicago.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Chicago. So let's check these out.
Oh, that's here in LA.
Okay, that's here in LA, but the next one, right?
Is that that's Chicago? In Chicago. Oh, yeah, that's okay. yeah, yeah. The story
so
behind
this
that
is
yeah,
one? And
yeah.
Then
we
the
did
LA
the
one.
Yeah, we did the boxes here in LA. We saw these three boxes that kind of modeled it after that Ferris Bueller's.
So cool.
But
I
then
love
when
that
we
joke.
Went to Chicago, we're like, we have to take Ferris to Chicago, and yeah. we did that.
Okay, good. When did you do the when did you do the LA one then?
We did
last summer.
Yeah, it was a year
okay,
ago.
Okay,
yeah.
so right before, right
absolutely.
Before you guys
yeah.
okay, did
yeah.
Chicago. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
So that's awesome. That's such a great movie. That's like a
it was good.
Iconic.
And
movie.
The piece it was really well received in both cities, so it was fun
I'm
to do.
Sure. Okay. So we didn't talk about the Food Just for Dogs and the value of what you do or what urban artists or street artists or artists in general do for commercial purposes, meaning to
yeah.
promote.
It's an interesting topic, and it's a very I don't know, there's a line you have to dance. I
yeah.
used to work
oh, for sure.
I used to work in advertising,
yeah,
so
yeah.
so I'm never going to cross that line. Like I'm never gonna I don't care how much money people throw at me, I'm not going to put some slogan up on a wall.
Especially a writer. They're not going to put words in your mouth.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I say yes as much as I say no yeah. to the companies that approach me. But the ones that get it allow me to do what I want to do. Like that Just Food for
yeah,
Dogs,
yeah, so
they
cute.
Had a great wall, mm-hmm. but I said I want to do this tongue-in-cheek quote from a movie.
The dogs were all cool about it.
Absolutely.
They were all pro wordsmith.
Yeah,
absolutely. So it's the companies that allow you to do what you want to do. And personally, I jump at if somebody has a wall that they'll give me, I jump at it. Like some people are like, oh, no legal walls. But I'm like, if the words are resonating with people
for sure.
resonating with people, I will put it up high. And the fact that it might last longer than it would in the streets, I jump at the chance.
Yeah, I think.
Okay, I have to show this video because this is very important because it takes a whole different realm goes into a whole different realm of inspiration. This particular musician singer actually found inspiration in wordsmith's words and created a entire song, of course co-written by wordsmith. So
yeah, she's a friend of mine.
Let's check that out.
Yeah.
Her name, Julia Price.
Julia Price.
I've fallen in love. The falling is great, but it scars. Never enough. And I gave up my brain for my heart. And you seem fine. Your voice kept a bit more distance than I. Well, fine. and I miss the fuck out of you. I miss the fuck out of you. Always wonder the only lie I ever told you was I liked you when I knew that I loved you. Oh, fuck out of you.
Okay, so that's some inspiration, right? I mean, so you actually collaborated on this song.
Yeah, it's a friend of mine, and she's a singer-songwriter, and like the companies I was just talking about, usually bands come to me and they're like, hey, put our lyrics up all over town. And I'm like, well, I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But Julia came to me and said, hey, I would like to look at all your words and construct a song.
Exactly. So
and we wrote it together. Yeah.
Okay. In
the lyrics.
So 95-98% of the word, your words are your words?
Yeah, 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 yeah. Every now and then I do some movie quote or a quote that, and it's usually something that I'm so jealous of, I wish I would have written it, so I have to tip my hat to it. But the other 98% is, and that's again why it works, it's I'm writing them.
Okay. Where can we find you?
Instagram, at Wordsmith, and it's Wordsmith with no vowels, WRDSMTH.
That's a way a writer would describe it. No vowels. Okay, you Meg Zany?
And I'm Meg Zany, MEGZANY.
Zany.
Indeed, and I'm at London Graffiti, as always, one word, and I've got every promo for every gallery show that's coming up, anything of interest in Los Angeles. On that note, we've got a show at Cave Gallery at the moment with Pure Evil from London, aka Charlie as Edwards, and Shay Two, who I hadn't been associated with before, and met him and the guy this weekend.
Yeah.
The guy's works up the fucking scale.
Up
like
the
everything.
Fucking scale.
Yep, and my Instagram is full of all the videos of this stuff, from Zane over at Chopping Down Films, who's doing great stuff with drones and documenting around the world, so I'm always sharing that content as well. So.
Very cool. Okay, and anybody who is going to be on a future show, anybody who's been on a show, all of those archives of any of those shows, future, present, or past, go to wetpuzzlepiece.com. All the social media is on there, social media junk, everything's on there, and I actually just created a separate urban art page, so check that out.
See,
because
that's how
we're
good it is.
Blowing up! Okay,
urban
so check it out. We'll see you next week. Next week, who do we have? I have LA. I forget. Something about rock and roll.
Yeah.
So tune in next week. Ciao for now.
Ciao, guys.
Bye.
Woo! We'll be right back.